secondary students in class.
Jacob and Zach are working on a portfolio of their math ability in order to hand it in for graduation.
Montage of students in class.
Students without vision often use a manual Perkins brailler, and they are essentially typing out their math line by line, and it's fascinating to watch. This term we've been working on all different types of graphs: line graphs, line plot, bar graphs, and scatter plot. When creating these graphs, I've tried to create high interest topics for them and also made them extra tactile for Zach, who struggles a little bit with his tactile ability, so that he's not held back. The data that we're using today is about the Super Bowl. We could have graphed it in a line graph or a different way, but today we're going to try it in a scatter plot. Okay, and so the problem that we're going to work on today is taking some information about, the data is the cost of a 30-second Super Bowl ad. Okay, it's the price of the ad, and then we're looking at it over Super Bowls numbers 1 through 50 and seeing what happens with the cost of the ad over time. I bet you guys can guess.
It's going to increase.
Right. For a student with no vision to read a graph, it actually has raised braille on it. And so the students have to tactilely feel as they're counting up one block, two blocks, three blocks in order to find the right spot to graph. And so for some students, they struggle with that. So sometimes I modify a graph as I add a tactile puff of paint so they can feel the blocks easier. If we go to 18, where did you think 18 was?
I thought it was like right there.
Okay, so go straight up to the line. Now when you hit the line, remember we talk about we're going to go, now we're in the middle of two boxes. Can you feel that?
Yeah.
Touches graph.
So I've been working with Jacob and Zach for 2 years now, so I know their learning style and I know their strengths and weaknesses, and I know how to accommodate them so it doesn't get in the way of their learning. So 1993 would have been 9 years later than Super Bowl number 18. So what Super Bowl are we on?
27.
Okay, so let's see how much that McDonald's ad cost at Super Bowl 27. When you look at it, see how, can you feel how it curves?
Yeah.
The dots? That's an exponential growth. Jacob has recently finished his math portfolio and now has the requirement to graduate from high school, so that was very exciting for all of us because he's been working on it for 2 years. Zach is at the very end of it. He's been working incredibly hard on his portfolio for the past 3 years, and he's in the final section of completing it. And so these students have the knowledge and they're very capable.
Jacob, Perkins student.
I like trying to use math skills whenever possible. A lot of the times, I mean, other classes I have and just in daily life. I write programs, not for a job, just for fun. And most of the time, I develop games. I make them, free that I just put them out there for entertainment.
Zach, Perkins student.
I'd say this is like one of my all-time favorite subjects.
Yeah, we're very similar, me and him, with liking math.